Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. I am Pradeep Pamgai and today we will look at the preview window in Filmora X. You will learn how to set playback quality so that there is no lag during playback, how to adjust zoom levels, enable snapping in the preview window, transform images and much more. So without further ado, let us begin. On the top right side of the interface, we have this big preview window to see our footage. This is where we can view our source media as well as our timeline media. If you click on a media, Filmora X will let us preview it in the preview window. We can also preview audio, titles, transitions, effects, elements, and split screens. At the bottom left, we have playback controls, backward, forward, play, and stop. Here is the slider that we can use to move forward or backward. These two buttons are mark in and mark out buttons used to rough edit a clip. We already discussed these in a previous video. We can use this field to set the playhead's current position. It is an editable field where we can enter a specific value to jump to a specific point in a video. This field displays time in hours, minutes, seconds, and frames. This drop-down here lets you change the playback quality of the preview window. You can lower the quality for smoother editing experience. This setting has no effect on the final render, it just defines the playback quality in the preview window. If you are working on a high-res video or you have applied lots of effects on a clip, you should lower the playback quality from here. Reducing your playback quality can eliminate lags and save you time. The next drop-down lets you change the project settings. If you have reduced the playback quality but you want to see the original frame when you pause your timeline, enable this option, Use Original Media when paused. To set zoom levels in the preview window, use these options. You can click on this icon to take a snapshot of the current frame. The snapshot will be imported in the Media tab and then you can use it as a regular media. The next icon is used to adjust the volume. This double-headed arrow is used to maximize the preview window. Press Escape to exit the full screen mode. When you select a clip in the timeline, selection handles appear in the preview window on the bounding box of the clip. Click and drag corner handles to resize clip in proportions. Drag the center handles if you want to stretch and squash your image. Use this handle to rotate the clip. When you move a clip in the canvas here, it gets snapped to the center of the canvas, edges of the canvas, and edges of other clips. If you want to disable snapping, right-click and uncheck the Enable Canvas Snapping option. If you select Show Safe Zones option from the context menu, two rectangles will be displayed. The outer rectangle is called Action Safe and the inner one is called Title Safe. Action Safe is 5% from all edges and Title Safe is 10% from all edges. Keep all essential elements inside the outer rectangle when designing text and graphics for the web. Keep all essential elements inside the inner rectangle when designing graphics and text for broadcast or cable. In the Go To menu, we have some commands to jump to a specific time in the timeline. To zoom in and out in the timeline, you can use these commands. If you have set in and out points in the preview window, you can clear them using this option. If you want to rotate or flip a video clip, double-click on the clip in the timeline. The video tab will appear here on the top left corner of the interface. It will open the transform area in this tab. Here you can use this slider to rotate the clip. You can also enter precise values here in this field. To reset the value, click on this icon here. Use these icons to flip the clip horizontally or vertically. Here we have a scale slider to change the scale of the clip. At the bottom, we have two parameters to change XY position of the clip. Every effect you see here has a checkbox. You can use these checkboxes to toggle the effects on and off. If you double-click on an image in the timeline, instead of the video tab, the image tab will be displayed over here, and then you can use these controls to change the position and scale values of the image. You are watching a video in a series of tutorials to help you learn how to use Filmora X. If this tutorial has helped you become a better video artist, please consider subscribing to the channel and ring that bell so you don't miss a thing. Thank you for watching.